Oh, hey, Shug. I was just sitting here by the crackling fire listening to some wonderful soothing Christmas music. Oh, I just love that. Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton, it's not Christmas without them. I'm just sitting here enjoying a glass of wine and thinking about the holidays, trying to unwind from the stress, and I got, fear ye not, I've got great news for you. I've got some wonderful stress-free recipes today that's gonna help you make it through your holiday season with a little less stress and a little more fun. So I want you to get in your favorite chair, get your laptops, pull them up too close to you, get up by the fire, pour your glass of wine, and come on back. Watch your show because it's a good one, honey. So I'll be home with bells on. I'll be home with bells on. From the tree and wrap presents, turn the Christmas music on. It's Christmas, I'll be home with bells on. Play one for us. Merry Christmas, you. Well, I know so many of you out there, hun, are planning on having a big old holiday party, and I don't know about you, but it's not Christmas unless you have a big old bowl of eggnog around, and you can go out and you can spend a lot of time making good old homemade eggnogs, beating up the egg yolks, making your base, and then, well, who's got time for all that? Takes a little time, but you know what? I got a little idea for you all out there today that's going to help you with save you some time, and people won't be any the wiser. You have to tell anybody that you have skimped on this, just me, you, and whoever's watching on the internets will know. So, what you do is go down to your local supermarket, grocery store, gas station, whatever, and get you, according to how many people you're going to have, some eggnog pre-made. There's nothing wrong with taking shortcuts. I know that we've been drummed and dry since we were little girls that, oh, homemade is best. Well, it is when you got the time, but if you got a job out there buying presents, wrapping them, hosting parties, mailing, addressing Christmas cards, I mean, it's no wonder we ain't all drunk. So what I want you to do is take a pretty bowl, get you a pretty bowl, and pour your prepared eggnog into the bowl. Now, what you're gonna do is add your, we got the egg, we need the nog. Justice, according to how many people you're gonna have, I got my vat already cooling out in the walk-in. So here we go, we're gonna have a cup of bourbon. Now, I want you to know that you can add more if you care to. But we don't want everybody to be drunk right off the bat. So next we're going to add a half a cup of rum. Now you can add a cup of rum if that's what you want to do, but we don't want to gild the lily, so to speak. Got that added to it. Now this is the wonderful part about this. You can just stir this up and this can be refrigerated until time to serve at your wonderful cocktail or open house or come as you are, whatever the hell you're having. Just mix it around, chill it. And when it's chilled and you're ready to serve, here's what you do, hon. Now you know how when you make real eggnog, you beat the egg whites and make it all frothy and pretty. Well, who's got time for that? I got drinking to do. So you take some whipped topping. You buy at the grocery store, whip topping, and you just lay it sort of haphazardly on top of your nog. You take your ladle and you smear it all around in there, hun. It's gonna separate and give you that nice frothy texture that homemade eggnog has. This reminds me of that Christmas that my sister invited me to come to her house for Christmas. Well, she served this eggnog. We had a little too much, of course. We don't know when to say when. That's one of the traits of my family. Of course, I'm staying in her double wide with her husband and four children, and they stick me into the little boy's bunk bed. I don't know if y'all noticed, I'm quite a voluptuous woman, so I just didn't know if I wanted to sleep on the child's bunk bed. Needless to say, that's where I passed out. I mean, went to sleep. So anyway, I woke up the next morning with a little kid running into the, hey Allysun, hey Allysun, get up, it's Christmas, Santa Claus has come. I felt like there had been a herd of reindeer landing on my head. I said, little boy, if you won't live to see another Christmas, you'll get out of this room and get Auntie Allysun some Alka-Seltzer. She's hung. Lord, I never puked so hard in my life. And eggnog is not the thing to throw up. Anyhow, we've discussed this on the show before, but I'm going to tell you right now, go easy on the nog, especially at your relative's house. And they got you in a little bunk bed. Hit my head on that thing, and oh, Lord, it was just a bad, oh, bad experience. Anyhow, let's get to top this off. To make it the finishing touch, the eggnog is fresh ground nutmeg, but we ain't doing that today because we're on time restraint. We all bought the ground nutmeg in a little container that you get at the grocery store. Just sprinkle it on the top. Oh, looky there. Is that not the crown? Aromatic, fragrant, gorgeous. Puts the finishing touch on your eggnog. Let's taste it. Cheers. Let's see. Ooh, takes me right back to the double wide. Anyway, I want y'all to go out there and make you some eggnog. And try not to hit your head on the bunk bed. And have a good time, eggnog. Needs more liquor in it.